Who carries on the populist agenda after President Trump?
Oh, I think now you're starting to see a whole type of populism evolve, hopefully in the Republican Party. I think the whole direction is there. Look at Ivanka. Ivanka's taken her time to focus on women's empowerment. So I think you're seeing throughout the administration, I think young politicians are starting to talk, Nikki Haley, all these, everybody's now focused on working class people and the concerns of the middle class and working class. And this is why I think it's been good. I think our democracy is more vibrant.
I smiled because it's hard to think of Ivanka Trump as a populist.
If you look at her actions, okay, and Ivanka and I have had a lot of fights, okay, but if you look at her actions, she's talking about women's empowerment. And so I think if you look at her and you look at other elements of the administration and young politicians coming up, every young politician understands today. They just can't give the happy talk to Wall Street. They can't just be a country club Republican. If you want to move forward, particularly on a national level, you have to understand that working class people, and this is the power, right now, this contest right now is between the right and the left. You got the Bernie and the Warren faction on the populist left, and you have the Trump revolution on the populist right. And that's what's really driving American politics right now. I think that's a healthy thing.